Hello, and welcome to Ask Swagelok. I'm Beth Neeser, and I'm here today with Buddy Damm, who's a senior scientist of metallurgy here at Swagelok. Today, we're going to be talking about corrosion in offshore oil and gas applications. So, Buddy, can you tell me what it is and what causes it?
So, corrosion occurs as a result of something called an electrochemical reaction, where you have electrons being lost from the metal, and the metal itself is reacting chemically. And corrosion scientists describe this in terms of two different half-cell reactions. So when a metal loses some of its electrons due to the environment, the corrosive environment, that's called oxidation. And then those electrons are transported through the metal to some local environment nearby and react in something called a reduction reaction. Okay. So the combination of the two is called a redox or reduction oxidation reaction. The net result of corrosion is that you're consuming the material, you're consuming the metal. And so you may get thinning of the metal and therefore loss of pressure containment, or you may get pitting or cracking or crevice corrosion, all damage that can result in mechanical reduction in performance.
So then can you explain to me what corrosion problems are common in an offshore platform environment?
So offshore, you can separate the types of corrosion. It's handy to separate them into two different types. There's an externally influenced corrosion and internally influenced corrosion. So externally influenced corrosion occurs because components are in a marine environment. There's salt water and sea spray. There's also elements and compounds from the actual production process on the platform that can all be corrosive. And in this environment, you can have wet and dry cycles. So when something gets wet, it may be relatively dilute, but then as the water evaporates away, the concentration of the corrosive elements and compounds or ions in the liquid become more concentrated, the environment gets more severe. And a couple of other things that can happen is you can get fretting corrosion, where you have two components that are rubbing against each other, and you would normally see some wear there, but the corrosive environment will accelerate that process. Okay. And then you can also get cyclic loading on components due to vibration or swaying of the platform itself. And that cyclic loading will result in fatigue. And if it's in a corrosive environment, fatigue can be accelerated due to the corrosion in something called corrosion-assisted fatigue.
Okay, and then what about internally influenced corrosion?
So internally, we're pulling hydrocarbons out of the ground. These wells can have a very broad range of chemical compounds in them, and each well might be different, but they can contain hydrogen sulfide or carbon dioxide. They may be very acidic. The deeper wells are higher temperature and higher pressure, so more aggressive environment. And we're containing pressure because these wells were pulling material from deep in the ground. And so the combination of the stress from pressure containment and this complex environment results in environmentally assisted cracking.
Okay, great. Well, thank you for that overview. And thank you all for joining us for Ask Swagelok.